And they handled it from there. They found no one, but found an open door on the second floor bathroom. Was someone actually in there and escaped? Or was it something else? When I was in uni, I lived by myself, and it was a nice little studio unit behind a house in a fairly decent area. I would honestly think nothing of walking to places at night. There was a 24-hour McDonald's and a 7-Eleven that I would walk to often between 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. since I was a massive sounds like me at Michigan State. I lived next to QD and like McDonald's, so I would frequently walk to get coffee and hot chocolate and a Big Mac. Well, one day after finishing an essay at about 2 a.m., I decided I was hungry, but it didn't really have anything easy to cook, so I decided to walk down to 7-Eleven and grab a pie or something. However, as soon as I opened the door, I was overcome by a suffocating feeling of fear. My heart started started shaking the works, telling myself that this was ridiculous. I walked out on the street with the intent to still go, but that was as far as I got. I was terrified for no reason that I could understand, but no less intensely despite that. I ran back inside and ate dry cereal. Later the next day, I heard about a group of drunk guys that were causing a havoc down near the intersection at 7-Eleven. They'd beaten up someone from my university. Even though I can't explain it, I'm convinced something bad would have happened to me that night if I had ignored that feeling and gone anyway. Sometimes when I go to bed, I wake up with deep line cuts on my body. Each time they're on different spots. My neck, leg, arm. See dry blood around the wound and on my sheets. Still don't know what the hell happened. It's only on my bed and my sheets. And my nails are cut short mostly.
Stop.